Most people have a pretty good idea of what a state park is and what goes on there. Most of us appreciate the value of historical sites, helping us to better understand our Texas heritage. But far fewer Texans know about the 1.5 million acres of public lands and wildlife management areas. Where are these places and what goes on there? Is this man a biologist or an arsonist? What's that coming out of this abandoned railroad tunnel? And why is this horned lizard wearing a backpack? A wildlife management area is like a laboratory, but without the walls. It's a place where biologists study an ecosystem and figure out ways to enhance the land for native wildlife. It's a place dedicated to research, demonstration, and education.
This is a live oak right here. In fact, that's a 30-year-old live oak tree. When you see white-tailed deer eating on live oak, there's hard times out there.
The goal is to share the knowledge with landowners so they can improve the quality of their property for wildlife.
This is hackberry. Hackberry's a good deer food. It's good cow food.
The Kerr Wildlife Management Area is famous for white-tailed deer research, but like many areas, a variety of studies are underway. Here at Old Sabine Bottom in East Texas, biologists conduct a baseline inventory to determine what animals live on the management area.
Essentially, we're looking for species presence, which means we're counting every snake, mammal, amphibian, bird, just more or less anything that we can get our hands on so that we know exactly what is here and what's not here.
These areas allow us to address some of the critical issues in wildlife habitat and management, whether it be endangered species or working with game species such as white-tailed deer or waterfowl or squirrels. But these properties allow us a land base on which to conduct these types of experiments and studies.
We've got 24 out, and we need 45.
Many people don't realize the type and number of research projects that we have going on these properties.
There we go.
Each lizard has its own frequency, so we can dial up for a particular animal.
And it doesn't just involve white-tailed deer or game species. There's a lot of research and management that goes on that concerns endangered species or threatened species or critical habitats or even non-game animals. These are the properties that allow us to do that type of work.
Is it?
Yeah, it looks like cactus wren to me. Yep, cactus wren.
Wildlife management areas were first created to service research and demonstration sites in each of the different ecological zones of Texas. Conversion of natural habitats to the needs and interests of people has long been blamed for the decline of wildlife. But what if the same tools that facilitated this decline could be used to reverse it? That was the idea of Aldo Leopold, professor of game management at the University of Wisconsin from 1933 to 1948 and the father of modern wildlife management. Leopold developed strategies for wildlife management using five basic tools. The axe, the cow, the plow, fire, and the gun. Biologists still use a combination of these concepts at wildlife management areas to promote plant and wildlife diversification. The axe equals a roller chopper in this case, which impedes brush from dominating this South Texas habitat. Buffalo that used to graze these lands were nomadic. Biologists imitate this type of grazing pressure by rotating herds of cattle from pasture to pasture. This protects the range from overgrazing and provides ample food for livestock and wildlife. The theory of the plow refers to planting of food plots or simple disking to provide additional food for wildlife.
Can you give me that temperature and humidity real quick again?
48% on the humidity and 71 degrees.
Historically, fires occurred frequently in nature. Now, biologists intentionally set fires under certain very specific atmospheric conditions. These prescribed burns help control invasive species in a very economical way. They also promote plant diversity, and the more diverse an area of land becomes, the better it is for the local wildlife.
Does anybody have any questions on what's a legal animal? This is an either-sex deer hunt by definition.
The gun refers to the proper use of hunting to control wildlife populations at a level that the land can sustain. This is incredibly important because overpopulation usually severely damages the habitat that both wildlife and livestock depend on.
Even though the concepts of wildlife management are the same all across the state, the specifics of the practice are a little different from ecological area to ecological area.
The smallest wildlife management area is also probably the strangest.
The Old Tunnel Wildlife Management Area is different from every other wildlife management area that we've got within the Wildlife Division in that we have, in this old abandoned railroad tunnel behind me now, a seasonal roosting site of approximately 2 million Mexican free-tailed bats.
These bats are more than a spectacular display of nature. They benefit the local community by consuming tons of destructive insects each night. Most areas benefit a wide variety of both plant and animal species. Mad Island and other new management areas along the coast provide critical habitat for millions of migrating and resident birds. While the emphasis is on wildlife, these are public lands, and many are accessible for a variety of activities.
To a mud hole in the water. The other thing that makes them reptiles is they lay eggs. Feels pretty neat.
Just let everything.
Who else hadn't touched them?
These living laboratories provide examples of what true stewardship can achieve. You may not be aware of the ongoing management by these dedicated biologists, technicians, and volunteers of the Wildlife Division, but their work will continue to enhance the rich natural heritage of Texas.